Alright, welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep at Terra's Root, and we are going to the Keyblade Graveyard. It is endgame time. We are up to level 20. Oh.
Do for friendship.
I just realized in that cutscene that I still have not changed. We've gone to how many worlds and I've had the same fucking Keyblade? Let's see. Ends of the Earth is good. Ooh, Chaos Ripper. Given that Terra is very much a... I really... That's how I won. That's how I've been winning all my battles, is I have to finally stop relying on magic and stuff and just go brute force with everything. And I know I keep saying brute force, but I can't think of a better term. But it's kind of annoying because that's not my typical playstyle, but it's kind of what Terra demands, because for whatever reason the magic just never has the same. Well, look at that giant ass Keyblade, goddamn. I'm gonna just mosey on, I guess. And I don't know. I don't... Now that I'm pretty much nearing the end of Terra's story, one, I kind of feel like Aqua was just exceptionally extra. I can't... Granted, it's been a long time since I played through Aqua's story. It's been a good 6 months. But I can't think of anything that you really learn in Aqua's story that couldn't have been, like, maybe a little edition here or there in Mantis or what Terra's playthrough, like, when they've just rectified everything. You know? I like this Keyblade, I gotta admit. Something I'm liking about... Terra's. God damn it, just fucking kill. I hate these, like, nebulous spaces. There's not really a ground. It's hard for me to see anything of what I'm doing. And they just keep coming. And, like, all of a sudden I'm falling and I don't know why. You know, levels and experience pretty quickly. That's the one benefit about this place, is that, I mean, you gain levels pretty damn quickly. And granted, part of it's because I'm probably severely underleveled. I don't know what the technical, like, best level to be at, but this is part of the reason why I play on the easiest mode you can, because I don't like leveling. It's really annoying to me. So... We're just gonna meld the two Kiras real quick so I can have my Kiraga. And once Firaga is done, I think I can get Flare or something like that.
Yeah.
to say in this portion of the game. I do find it weird that these... I guess this is like just a combination of everything that you fought. It feels a little lazy now that I'm playing through this the third time. And here's the Peter Pan enemies. Oh my god, I hate these bitches. There we go. And tornadoes are chasing me, which is always fun. Don't you love it when tornadoes chase you? Isn't it the best thing ever? What level am I at now? I haven't really been paying attention. Like, I keep seeing these things pop up, but sometimes it's for abilities, and... I don't know, I just want these things to die and move on. But at the same time, I'm like, am I gonna be way too severely underleveled for this game? For the end game? I hate these bitches. Oh my god. Stop, you fucking... Oh my god. Can I just... Good. That doesn't tell me what my level is, but at least when I retry, it looks like I get to keep all of my previous, EXP, which is nice. That's a nice feature. Really? Die. Die, you horrid beast. Now that I think about it, where's my glide? Where's my glide ability? So I'm at level 26 now. And I'm half expecting that thing to catch up with me. Ooh, you know what? Let's see, though. So, Kiraga, Blackout, Stoppa, those have all finished. And now we have two Firagas, which means we get... Oh, seriously, I can't just combine them? Well, then why the hell was I saving that one? Alright, let's combine Blackout with it and just see what we get. Oh, that looks cool. That looks like a fun thing. I like that. Alright, and I guess we'll combine it with a Stoppa. Crawling fire. Ooh. And you know, I think I'd rather keep the Zara. And then what can we do with this one? We will put Zara there. And we're gonna get rid of this and put Mind Square back in. And we're also gonna get rid of the Zero. Put, there we go. Oh, okay, one more. One more. Maybe I'll get to try out some of this new stuff, though. not him. These fuckers. There we go. Didn't get another level up, but that's okay. We're pretty much there. And you know what, I know there's going to be a save point, and if it doesn't end up working out, I can always go back and level up some. But I think we have a pretty good selection. But you know, we do have 12, 17. Let's see if there's anything, like, this is the end game, so let's see, there's Blitz, ooh, Dark Haze, cloak yourself in darkness, that's not really gonna work. Fire Surge, Rusty Enemy, well, ooh, that one looks good, let's get that. And then, anything else, like, super, ooh, Ignite. Ignite the enemy. Ooh, I like that one. Okay, let's sell. Let's sell. I want to sell that one. We will sell Strike Raid, though, and see if we can. And Freeze Raid, because it takes too long, and we're just sitting ducks while waiting for it. We're going to get rid of the Poison Edge, too. And then we will buy... Where's my Ignite? I want Ignite. Ignite. There we go. And then we are going to go to our command decks. And we are going to sacrifice Zara, because it's not worth it. And then Daga. Ooh, do we want... tough call. Because he ends up standing still for so long, and there is no instant kill with bosses, I'm going to go ahead and let this one go. So that way I can have Ignite. And, you know, we're gonna just kind of hope for the best here. We're just hoping for the best. And then it's time to watch that same cutscene we've seen at least twice now. So... hallway for no reason. I mean, they could have at least made it interesting, really.
I was told the master was struck down.
Yes, that's right. I was stupid and helped Xehanort do it. The master, he tried to hurt Ven. I only fought because I wanted to protect him. But I was tricked. Xehanort set the whole thing up. Also, he could awaken the darkness inside me. You were right, Aqua. And so was the Master. I did need to be watched. I went astray. But no more.
What else is darkness but hate and rage. Xehanort is feeding the dark fires within you, making you fight. You'll go astray again. Tell me, how does that honor our master's memory, Terra?
Xehanort wants me and Vanitas to fight and make some kind of keyblade. But the Master said we can't let that happen. And he tried to destroy me for it.
Keyblade?
I still don't know exactly what it is. But it scares me to death. Even just the thought of it.
Relax, Ben. We're here, and we're gonna take care of you.
I may have to fight Vanitas after all. If I do, guys, I want you to...
The three of us can never be torn apart, all right? I'll always find a way.
I'm asking you, as a friend, just put an end to me.
Lifeless keys used to be full of power, united with the hearts of their masters. On this barren soil, keyblades of light and darkness were locked in combat. As a great keyblade war raged, countless keyblade wielders gave up their lives, all in search of one ultimate key. And it will soon belong to me. Keyblade!
Okay.
I knew this was a journey you could make. Over the unseen wall that divides darkness and light. And I was not wrong, Terra!
My friend,
Ven. You tell me, Xehanort. What did you do to him?
Why, I did him a favor and freed the darkness inside him. Alas, poor adventurers never have the fortitude for such strenuous trials.
Xehanort!
Alright, so before we start this battle, we are actually at time, so I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching.